Well, the woman at the centre of Victoria's deadly mushroom lunch is expected to face court today in a case that has gripped the nation and the world. Erin Patterson has been charged with murdering her former in-laws, Gail and Don Patterson, and Gail's sister, Heather. They all died after allegedly eating a poisonous beef Wellington that Patterson served for lunch at her Leongatha home in July. She's also facing five counts of attempted murder and has not yet been required to enter a plea. For more, we're joined by criminal defence lawyer Celine Curry from Silk Lawyers. Good morning to you. Well, where is the Erin Patterson's case in the legal process right now? What's this hearing all about today?
Middle stage. So committal matters are still in the magistrate's court. It's kind of a part of the legal process where prosecution and defence will have a chat about any areas that are in issue about evidence. They have the chance to cross-examine witnesses if they so choose in the committal process. And essentially, a magistrate will ultimately make a ruling in the committal stream as to if there is enough evidence for the matter to go to trial. And if they find that there is enough evidence for the matter to go to trial, then Ms. Patterson will be asked how she intends to plead, and then the matter will be uplifted in this situation to the Supreme Court.
Well, you can only assume that Victoria Police have enough evidence to this point to get things going. How long could this whole process take?
I mean, how long's a piece of string, really? It's all pretty dependent on how Ms. Patterson's legal team want to proceed with the matter. If she is not wanting to cross-examine any of the witnesses, if she's not wanting to engage in any of the committal processes, then I think we could see it uplifted relatively quickly. It'll just be a matter of a magistrate deciding if there is or isn't enough evidence, and then her entering a plea of guilty or not guilty and it being uplifted. But if it is that she does want to cross-examine those witnesses, well, you can imagine how many witnesses there are in this case, or how much evidence or witnesses they might want to subpoena. And that could be a very lengthy process before we see it uplifted.
Yeah, that's right. That's happening today. A lot of interest in this one. Celine, thanks for your time.